Okay, so I'm going to show you how to ease around a circle or a curved part. I'm in the middle of making some arm covers for a sofa, and they're a rolled arm. So I'm making this curve to match the sofa, and I'm going to show you how to ease around a curve. This is the shape of the arm of the sofa, and I'm going to attach this piece of fabric in order to make the arm cover. So this is the top of it, and then there'll be another piece here that'll have that same curve. The first thing that you're going to do is line up the corners, and then we're going to snip into the curve. And you want to snip no deeper than your seam allowance. So if you're doing a 5/8 inch seam allowance, don't go any deeper than that. But you do need to go almost as deep as your seam allowance, because otherwise it won't lay down flat. So now, let's see if I can get this so you can see it better. I'll do it this way. Okay, so I snipped into it on that curve. Lay that down, and we're going to pin this, but you see how now that those little snips allow your fabric to get around that curve and lay down flat? If I didn't do those, like this side here, we would not be able to make it around that. Your fabric would get all bunched up here and it just would not lay down flat. You would end up sewing over these gathered pieces, and you don't want that. So that's why you have to snip into it. So I'm gonna pin this real, put a few pins in here, and then we'll take this to the sewing machine and I'll show you how to sew the easing. So just make sure that your edges are, you know, the same. Don't. And I usually put a lot of pins in around the curve. And once you get better, more experienced at this, you can just do this at the sewing machine, particularly if you have a walking foot, but if you're a beginner, we'll go ahead and pin the heck out of it. Okay, so you see how that?
So I've got my arm cover here and it's all pinned, and I'm going to sew in a 1/2 inch seam allowance. And I've got my, just my regular, I guess this is actually called a zigzag foot, but my wide flat foot. I like to do kind of a medium length stitch, not my longest stitch, because this is going to get a pretty good amount of tension on it when we start to press it, and also when it's on the sofa, it could end up getting pulled pretty tight. So we're going to do a medium stitch, not the longest. Okay, and once we get to the curved part, this is where you want to start easing. Let me see if I can bring this in a little closer at a better angle.
Okay, so that's better. So when you start to get to the curved part, all these gathers here, you want to, as you're sewing, pull them away from your presser foot. So I'll show you as we go. And you want to make sure you keep your seam line nice and lined up, even as you're going around the curves. And when I'm easing like this, I generally will keep my pins in and just be careful when I'm sewing over them, because I don't want my fabric shifting on me. So you see how we've got a little pucker here, and if we leave it like that and continue to sew, we might end up with a little gather. So I'm going to pull this fabric this way and just flatten it out. And if you need a little help flattening it out, I use my, either sometimes my scissors or seam ripper. And so we got another gather here, and you just pull it back that way. So that's how you ease around a corner. And I'll do another one, because that one was actually pretty easy. That one wasn't difficult, but let me show you how this looks when we take it out, and then we'll take it to the ironing board and I'll show you how to press it, or how I press it. So
So, see that? This one was actually really easy. The other ones that I did were a little bit more difficult.
So I don't use an ironing ham because it's just not stiff enough for me. So I generally will use this little portable ironing table. Put all of your seam allowance to one side. Fit it over the corner, and actually I usually put it toward the center. Fit it on there and pull it pretty taut over that corner. And that's why you want to do a smaller stitch. And then press it. There we go, I made it a little darker so you can see that seam a little bit better. See how nice that looks. Here's one of the arm covers that I did, and they're not pressed yet, so you see how there's a lot of what looks like puckering on that seam as well as there. See how that looks a mess? Pressing is so important. So let me press these. Okay, there we go. Let's see if I get it to focus. You see how nice and neat that is? That front seam, the side seam. See how nice that looks?